Shukramana University. I have been an English teacher for a period of 15 years. I am very much interested in English language teaching. I am here to describe the ELT scenario that is there prevalent in Tamil Nadu. At the beginning, when I joined Anna University in 1975, we tried to teach language through literature. Then in 90, we were introduced to ELT, communicating language teaching. In late 80s, British Council Chennai introduced a material design project, and our Vice Chancellor, Dr.V.C. took it up with a lot of interest because he was very much interested in language teaching. And the project went on for nearly 5 years, and 4 teachers were trained in UK. So just then it had taken, the communicative language teaching had taken its roots. It started in the 70s, and we were introduced to all the concepts related to communicative language teaching in the late 80s. So I was there from 89 to 90. And all along I had done only literature, and I didn't have faith in the efficacy of the methods advocated by the British experts at the beginning. But slowly I got initiated into the field of ELT. And from then onwards, I've been a teacher researcher. So ELT, see, all people working in technical institutions tend to call themselves ELT experts. And ELT now is not a very simple thing, I would like to tell you. Now it's an ocean. ELT experts have given us so many things. They made so many experimental studies, and they have given us guidelines to follow. Now, communicative language teaching, as I told you, took its roots in Spain, and it was very much favored. It was the much favored, and it was the most favored method of language teaching in the 20th century, in the beginning of the 20th century, we could say. And see, now, here communicative competence was the aim of all second language learners. It's the aim of the second language learners also. Now, communicative language or teaching is a linguistic phenomenon, I would say. And so communicative competence comprises lexical competence and grammatical competence and strategic competence. So, as a teacher of English, we are supposed to develop the lexical knowledge of students, or the grammatical knowledge of students, and the socio-cultural knowledge of students. So, with all these basic ideas in mind, we teach. I think we could do effective teaching of language. So, this is the message that I would like to tell you during this session of mine. Now, here, see, take this area of vocabulary teaching. Now, vocabulary teaching, teachers have this notion that you just introduce the words to them. Of course, these days they speak much of the task-based learning, right? Task-based learning. And they think they can teach the items, the vocabulary items, through activities, right? But, there are so many theories that are related to vocabulary teaching and learning. I would like to ask the teachers that they should familiarize themselves with all the experimental studies that have been done in the area of vocabulary teaching. Okay, there is a group of 10 or 15 inner department or 5 or 6 inner department. One can try to really know the important books related to the development of lexical knowledge. She can have discussions in reading with other teachers. Similarly, with the other aspects of language use, the grammatical accuracy of the language, and work with the related areas, the other related areas. And here, you know, similar, I would like to tell you one thing. Apart from the teaching of vocabulary and grammar, we'll have to concentrate on the teaching of the functions, the communicative functions of the use of language. It's very, very important. Now, here, let me say and say that language is performative in art. When we use language, we do one action, one act, rhetorical act or the other. Now, here they say, now we have been introduced to the concept of technical English. So what do the scientists do when they use language? They try to define, describe and classify hypotheses and these are all the scientific functions. When they use language, they will have to use language in such a way that they perform these functions very, very effectively. Okay, here so our language use becomes function focused here, right? And then we feel that our students should be experts in communication skills, and they want us to do the four major skills, you know, LSRW, listening, speaking, reading and writing. These are the four major communication skills, and so we follow the function focused syllabus and skills oriented syllabus, and the skills they feel, I mean, the linguist researchers have, you know, taught us how to help students develop their skills through the use of tasks. So we are, I mean, you know, almost all of us, all English teachers follow the activity-based syllabus. So task-based syllabus. Okay, right. Here, you know, see, there are misconceptions. People have mistaken notion for how the task-based syllabus should be. How tasks, activities can be made to work to teach the students as the communicative aspects of the use of language. Now, here, see, they find it very easy to download the activities from the computers and they go and they administer all the tasks with the students in a very, very interesting way, and they are excited and all that. But the question is whether real learning takes place or not. Now, you'll have to make experimental studies. You'll have to think of what aspect of language use you are aiming at while you make the students perform that task. That is very, very important. And of communicating method of teaching. Now, so here, when you follow this method, you aim at developing the lexical knowledge of students, the grammatical knowledge of students, and the sociolinguistic competence of students, and the strategic competence of students. Much of the efficacious use of technology, that is called computer-aided language learning, computer aided vocabulary teaching and learning, and all that. I'm not against it, I'm for it only. But you make a judicious use of both methods. See, you can't do away with the traditional methods of teaching at all. See, in ELT, there are ELT researchers recommend so many methods of teaching. They have recommended from time immemorial, so many methods of teaching. See, the drill based method, the audio-linguistic method, the communicative method, the interactive approach, learner-centered approach, learning-centered approach, discourse and teaching of discourse, you know, aspects, the disposal aspects of language and all that. See, I did MA ELT E90 in UK, and my first director was Tricia H. When I interviewed her and asked her what her favorite methods were, she said, no, see, you can't disregard. I don't have any particular, I don't favor any particular method. See, each and every method has pedagogic value in it. See, so you can't disregard the value, the pedagogic value of any particular method. The teachers should aim at developing the communication skills of students. As I've already pointed out, there are four skills, that is speaking, reading and writing. And so teachers, ELT teachers, should try to specialize themselves in the teaching of all the four skills. See, in 90, I was introduced to the concepts related to the teaching of writing skills by Tricia Hedge, the specialist in the teaching of writing skills, and she got the award from the Queen that year for her book on writing. So from 90 onwards, I have been doing a lot of research about the teaching of writing. A teacher should be a teacher researcher, doing research all the time. See, these days they speak of learning styles, learning strategies. So you should, try out what strategy or the other to do skills teaching for them. Okay, so writing, writing alone people should take up and try to specialize in. See, going through all books, all important books related to skills development, learning all the methodologies, learning the experimental studies and all that. And she can share her knowledge with others. Similarly with the other skills also, learning, reading and speaking. And so that's it. An ELT teacher can never say that I know the ways and means of teaching all skills. No, not like that. So you have to equip yourself with all knowledge. And one of the important area in ELT is testing and evaluation. So there has been so much of research work has been done in the area of testing and evaluation. So they say testing is a teaching device. By giving tests, you teach them one component, linguistic component or other. So all these ideas you should have in mind and update your knowledge. And then your style of teaching, should a language teaching, should improve day by day. So have all these in mind, and this is all from my experience and with all humility I give.
Thank you. Thank you so much.